After Besigye and Mukaku were denied bail by Buganda Road Magistrate Court last week, their lawyers ran to the High Court challenging the decision of the lower court. During the hearing of the petition today, the lawyers informed court that it is their client's constitutional right to apply and be granted bail, and since they have fixed places of residence and substantial sureties, they will not abscond and they have complied with earlier conditions on bail. For Besigye alone, his lawyers argued that he is being persecuted by the state because he has faced several charges that the DPP has withdrawn without trial, and that he was under house detention in May this year by police and other security personnel who barred him from executing his duties, and when he attempted to come out, he was arrested and charged with inciting violence.
This one may not have applied. It is our demand.
Besigye's lawyers presented five sureties, including Besigye's wife Winnie Byanyima and the Deputy Lord Mayor Doreen Nyanjura, to bail them out, whom the state didn't object to. However, Senior State Attorney Isaiah Wanamama objected to Besigye's release on bail, saying his application was incompetent before the High Court.
What you were saying, they should have come to support the ruling from yesterday, showing that they have been denied bail where there is a pending suit, and that will be when this matter will be right for this court.
In his ruling, presiding judge Tadeo Asimwe rejected Besigye's bail application, saying the lawyers should have petitioned the chief magistrate's court instead of the High Court. The ruling was read by the deputy registrar of the High Court, Didas Mahomuza.
Section 77(3) does not create a concurrent jurisdiction between the High Court and the chief magistrate's court, as counsel for the applicant wants this court to believe, but rather highlights on which court one can file a fresh application, depending on which court denied the earlier bail.
Asimwe, however, condemned prosecution for the wrong procedures brought into this matter, which wasted a lot of court's time.
I hope this in future will be done correctly.
After court, we talked to Besigye's lawyers, who expressed disappointment with the way the case was handled by Justice Asimwe.
And before court is that it has jurisdiction, but it is not going to hear the bail application. So it feeds into the erosion of confidence, public confidence, in our judicial system.
Unfortunate that even the High Court can abdicate on its own obligations, hiding under what we call technicalities.
The lawyers, however, agreed that they go ahead and file another petition in the Chief Magistrate Court as advised by Justice Asimwe. They are, however, skeptical about getting any justice in the lower court.
That court has two chief magistrates. There is Kamasanyu and Dr. Singiza. So whoever is there is going to handle us. In any case, if at all we fail to get any chief magistrate there, we shall write to the chief registrar to get any person who can handle us.
Dr. Kizza Besigye and Samuel Lubega Mukaku have been in detention since June 15, following their arrest in downtown Kampala for encouraging Ugandans to rise up against government inaction, cushion vulnerable citizens against skyrocketing commodity prices. They were arraigned before Buganda Road Court and charged with incitement of violence 2 days after their arrest. However, the presiding magistrate, Asuman Mahumuza, declined to release them on grounds that they had become habitual offenders. This report was compiled by Rachel Nachiwala for the news.